Good evening, everyone. RedTacton. I'm Chitra.
I'm Divya.
I'm Srinivas.
And this is as a part of our coursework. First of all, human area networking. We have a lot of technologies nowadays like Bluetooth, infrared communication, and RFID, which are used to send data from one device to another. But in 1996, IBM introduced a technology called intra-body communication, in which it describes about the some of the parts of the body which are used to transfer data from one device to another. So this is what human area networking is, and the communication is possible using some of the parts of the body like hands, fingers, arms, feet, face, legs, and toes. When IBM introduced this technology, many research groups tried to focus on this, but due to some of the limitations, they could not succeed. Some of the limitations are like the operating range through the body was limited to few tens of centimeters, and the top communication speed was only 40 bits per second. The technology later on implemented by NTT, that is Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Corporation, that is located in Japan, and they could overcome the limitations. So the technology named as RedTacton. Here the red implies the warmth according to the Japanese, and tacton, T represents touch, and acton represents action. So this is how the word implemented, that is RedTacton. And here the it uses the intra-body communication, that is if we catch two devices, one in this hand and one in this hand, with the help of the electric field produced by our body, the data is transferred from this device to this device. So this is how it works, and the speed is like 10 Mbps. Thank you.
While coming to the principle of RedTacton, this is basically based on two devices, which is transmitter and receiver. Here, the transmitter sends the information to the body, which acts as itself acts as a medium to transfer the data, and then while receiving at the receiver, it detects the data and transfers to the circuit through the laser. This is the actual process goes on. The RedTacton relies upon the principle that the optical properties of the electro-optic crystal, according to the changes of weak electric field that is in the ground. So RedTacton detects the changes in the optical properties of electro-optic device and using a laser, and then converts to the electric circuits, and then it transmits to the circuit. The experiment on the human body shows the process that how it goes on. Here, the two devices place in one hand and in another hand. Here, it goes the data from one hand to another hand, but not only from one hand to another hand, it goes through the cloths and shoe even to reach the ground. So, using a RedTacton electro-optic sensor, two-way communication is supposed between any parts in the body itself at a speed of 10 Mbps. So communication is not just confined to the surface of the body, it travels to the cloths and shoes and again. So RedTacton device, unless wireless technologies, the transmission speed does not interrupt because the body itself makes the medium, so there is no interruption to transfer the data. So so that is why, because the body surface is the transmission path. And then while coming to the human safety, the RedTacton is the latest human area networking technology. Since the body of the person acts as a transmission medium, it is completely covered with insulation, so there is no chance to get the electric power into the human body. But as per radio frequency exposure protectance standard, it is not that much levels supposed to insulate the power to the human body. So next, the features is continued by Srinivas.
Hi everyone, I'm Srinivas and I'll be continuing with the next part of my presentations with the RedTacton. So there are many technologies in the markets, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and Zigbee technologies and in infrared. So why RedTacton has been introduced for these existing technologies? Since there is advancement in the technology, so the technologies which are existed in the present market, such as Bluetooth, the Wi-Fi and Zigbee technologies, have been somewhat overrated. A Japanese company named Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Corporation has done several research on this to introduce a new type of transmission of data by using the transmission of data by using the human area networking. So what human why they have founded human area networking? If our human body will generate a minute electron particles, so by using the electron particles from our body, it can generate an electric field. So the human body acts as a surface to generate the data from which can take place at a higher rate. Speaking about the features of the RedTacton, so there are many features, but some of the basic features I would be dealing with that. It is touch, broadband, and interactive, and they will be useful for in any media. So I'll be dealing with each of the cases. So touch. Touch here. Here communication can be made by just simple touch or by just standing over there. You can have the communication can be done. Here you can see that touching and gripping, stepping and all walking can be acted as a triggers so that they will be turned on and off whenever the action is performed. So just by touching, the communication will be performed. The RedTacton devices will be handled on one hand, and on one hand in the sense it may be in a computer or in your mobile, and the other device will be performed there. So just by touching it, whatever the action you need, you will be getting easily. Next, broadband and interactive. RedTacton performs both two sides of a communication. Wireless LAN. If you see in a conference, they are all sitting here. So they uses a LAN, and by using this, they all depends on these two LANs. Whereas in a RedTacton, each one will be having their own device. So they will not be having any issues with the speed. So there will be no interference of a data. So the transmission of data will be very speed in this technology. So this technology can be used on any surface of the materials. They are used in by using conductors and by using dielectrics. And you can see there they can be used on any surface of the body, and even on the shoes. It can be used on the by using the clothing, on the walls and etc. But the metal should be as a conductors or dielectrics, and even they can be both dielectrics and the conductors. So I would like to compare this RedTacton technology with the older technologies which are already existed in the market, like Bluetooth, Zigbee and Wi-Fi. The RedTacton will be taking place between wireless communication devices and between wired communication devices. If you take Wi-Fi technology has no physical connection. But the signal comes as soon as the data will be transmitted as soon as the signal as arrives. But what the problem here is, the problem with the Wi-Fi will have a security problem. There will be a lot of problem with security. But if you take the wired communication devices, here the data transmission speed will be low compared to although the speed will be high in the Wi-Fi, there will be a security problem there. But here the transmission speed will be low. So, but whereas in RedTacton, it uses a human service body as a communication medium. So the transmission, the data transmission will be very high in RedTacton. So that is why it is placed between wired communication and wireless communication devices. Why? Because if you see in general, you will think that RedTacton is also a wireless communication device, but it's not. Since our human body accesses surface of the data of a transmission device, it has wired communication device. So it is placed in between wired and wireless communication devices. So RedTacton has focused on many fields. You can take it is mainly used in the medical fields. And they are also used in a data communication fields, and also in various organizations. But see, I can give a simple example how these RedTacton will be used. Suppose if a patient is having some diseases, so he wants to find. He wants to find the medicine. He wants to locate. He wants to go there and find the medicine. So the patient will be having a RedTacton device. So the medicines will also be having the RedTacton are equipped with, embedded with this RedTacton device. So if a patient catches the wrong medicine bottle, then the alarm triggers. Then he'll be able to know. So what that he. He is using the wrong medicine bottle. So you can see here, there are in this picture you can see the various applications that RedTacton has got here. Just by catching a RedTacton device, here communication can be made between your mobile and headset. And just by having a physical connection, the data will be exchanged between the two persons. And in the second picture, you can see here. And if you see in this case. If you have a RedTacton device in an organization, we will be having a check-in. Without check-in, we cannot enter. We cannot enter inside. But if you have a RedTacton device, that it will be automatically detected, and the access will be done for him. So he is hearing the music by just standing in front of that. He will be just standing there, and he will be getting the details. Whatever the details he needs, he will be getting just by standing over there and by just touching the button over there. So there are various applications in the RedTacton. So the performance of the RedTacton is much more high than compared to the technologies which are existed now, such as Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and Zigbee. And there is no problem of hacking, but only the disadvantage is this device is more costlier than the other technologies. That's it. Thank you.
And the communication is possible using some of the parts of the body, like hands, fingers, arms, feet, face, legs, and toes. When IBM introduced this technology, many research groups tried to focus on this, Good evening, everyone. RedTacton. I'm Chitra.
I'm Divya.
I'm Srinivas.
Device to another. So this is what human area networking is. And the communication is possible using some of the parts of the body, like hands, fingers, arms, feet, face, legs and toes. And this is as a part of our coursework. First of all, human area networking. We have a lot of technologies nowadays like Bluetooth, infrared communication, and RFID, which are used to send data from one device to another. But in 1996, IBM introduced a technology called intra-body communication, in which it describes about the some of the parts of the body which are used to transfer data from one device to another. So this is what human area networking is.